if the warlock in the 80s grew up, this is what came out 20 years later, right? Okay, hello everybody, welcome back. We're gonna get started with one of those bad boys right there. So, I recently did a video on a warlock that I sold, and I figured I would counter that video with a warlock that I don't plan on selling. You know, I'm a huge BC Rich fan, I think everybody knows that. And, you know, like I mentioned in that video, you can't keep everything that you acquire over time, so sometimes you need to make decisions, and a lot of times the decision I'll make when I sell something is, you know, you want to get rid of a duplicate, that type of thing. So in that particular case, you know, I let that warlock go, which was a gorgeous warlock. It was made in Japan. It had that very unique color. But this video is about this warlock and why I have it in my collection, what I like about it. And, you know, this is really just an opportunity for me to visit some old guitars that have literally been in my collection for many years. So this one here, obviously, is a warlock. It's a BC Rich warlock. I'll give you a close-up of that headstock. This one here is the NJ Neck Through series, as it indicates there. Now, this one here is Korean made. This one was made at the Fine Corporation. That's the name of it. The Fine, F-I-N-E, Corporation in Korea. These came out, I believe it was 1999. This one here is made in 2000. So at the time of making this video, it's 19 years old, okay? Never gigged with this. And again, this has never even showed up in a video of mine. So it goes to show you how vast the collection is. This one, but what I love about it, first of all, like the other one had a very 80s, that pearl finish, the purple burst, gorgeous guitar. This one here is a little bit more subdued. You could see it's actually pine. The wings on here are called milky pine. It has rosewood stringers, which are these strips, are basically wood strips that hold the wings to the neck. It's a neck through, as we could see there, and it's actually a three-piece neck through. And you could see, it's actually easier to see over here. You could see the three pieces of the neck. So you have a maple neck through, rosewood stringers, milky pine wings that are beveled on not only on the front but on the back, and you could see how nice those bevels are. It's just really a beautiful display of you know, craftsmanship here. The back of the heads. This is the Widow headstock, which I think actually looks really cool for the warlock. It really just, I don't know, I just love the way it looks. What else could I tell you? So it has these bevels. Now, again, milky pine, but it has that veneer, very subtle flame top. There you go. You could see it right there. Very subtle on the top and the bottom. So it's got this very subtle flame veneer. On the top, you could see the three-way come through on right under the licensed Floyd Rose trem. These here are the BDSM pickups. I forget what that stands for. If you know, leave it in the comment below. Nice bound neck on here. Nice cream. I don't know if it was always cream, but it's cream now. Cloud inlays, rosewood fretboard. And I feel like it's... I don't know. I really like the... This one actually here is called the NJ Neck Through Series. NJ. And this is... It's funny how they did a throwback to the NJ series. But the reality is this really... you know, outside of the Warlock body shape, it was nothing like the other guitar I showed you. It wasn't like what they were producing in Nagoya, Japan. But a lot of companies like to reuse, you know, names. I guess it's to protect the... I don't know, the name, I don't know. Fender does that, right? They just reissued the Tone Master in their new electronic version of things like the Twin and the Deluxe Reverb, even though the Tone Master was its own amp way back then, way back when. So companies do like to reuse their names, and my guess here is the tribute to NJ Neck Through Series is a throwback to just something that they owned. which was the NJ series. And this one here, again, I think it's like a mature version of a Warlock. Like if the Warlock in the 80s grew up, this is what came out 20 years later, right? Less about the flash of the pearl and the purple, more about the very Les Paul style, that Gibson Les Paul style burst. I mean, if this looked like a Les Paul paint-wise, this is a Les Paul standard in iced tea finish, right? That's kind of what's here. So I feel like this is what a Warlock looks like when it's not in its teens anymore, but it's, mid-20s, that type of thing. And this one here, 85, this is 15 years older than the other one that I had shown you in the other video. And I just think it's a great example of a Warlock that doesn't have to look black and metal, and a Warlock that doesn't have to look like, glam scene era either. It's just an elegant looking Warlock. And also, I do like, this is another throwback, is that, I don't know if it's real walnut, but the walnut veneer on the headstock, which I think looks kind of, again, classy. This here is what I would call a classy Warlock, okay? And I think it's just, it's a great example of that you could take something as pointy as this and really just make it look classy with that vintage style paint job, the very subtle veneers to, just make it pop. Like over here, you can't really tell, but when you come up, you could really appreciate those flames. And again, I think the bevels just make it really, just pop the bevels on the back. Nice access neck joint over here. So I wanted to share this one with you. And, I have a lot of guitars in my collection. I've been collecting long before this channel ever started. And I would like to share some of my collection with you. So if you dig this sort of thing, let me know in the comments. I read the comments all the time. And a lot of times the comments will dictate what comes out next. So leave your comments. Let me know what you'd like to see. And I'd be happy to share with you my collection. So that's all I have for you. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got to enjoy this guitar here. By the way, for those that like collecting guitars, I believe that the NJ Neck Through series also came in the Mockingbird and the Gunslinger, or maybe it was called the Assassin. So this came in a few different body shapes. But this one I bought at a music store. It was hanging on the wall. I'll look at the, let's see how that flame is popping just like that. That flame is popping right there. It's all how the light catches it. And I bought it and it was, I like the guitar, so I hope you like it too. So I want to thank you for watching my video. I'm going to leave everyone off with one of those, and I will see you later.